Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about shear stress distribution for I section. So here I section dimensions are given, that is 350 mm depth and 200 mm width, and having web thickness 12.5 mm and flange thickness 25 mm, and it carries a shearing force of 200 kN. So for this we have to draw the shear stress distribution across the section. I'll show you the I section. So this is 350 mm deep and 200 mm width and 20 mm flange thickness and 12.5 mm web thickness. So this is web and these two are flanges. Okay, so first we have to know that this is a symmetrical I section. Why? Because dimensions are all same, 200 mm, 200 mm and 12.5 mm. Okay, so this is a symmetrical I section. So given load is 200 kN and x bar is nothing but centroid of the x. So 200, this is x axis. So this is 200 mm, half of this is 200/2, that is x bar, centroid 100 mm. And next y bar, that is 350. So 350/2, 175 mm. Okay, so after that we have to find out the moment of inertia about the neutral axis. So this is the neutral axis. In this neutral axis we have to find the moment of inertia. So I am taking Ixx. So moment of inertia formula is BD³/12, because here first I am considering this entire section as a rectangle. See here, I closed all these. Okay, actually I is this one, but here I closed all the, I mean this portion and this portion, then it becomes a rectangle. So what I am doing is, first I am doing moment of inertia for this rectangle, that is capital BD³/12 minus this inner portion, nothing but I am detecting this whole rectangle into, I mean subtracting this little one, minus 200 minus 12.5. In this 200, this 12.5 is there, so I am detecting 12.5, that is b value, small b, and d cube is this one, up to here it is 350. So our flange thickness is 25 mm. So 25 plus 25 is 50. After detecting 350 minus 50, we will get 300, that is 300 depth of this one, okay, by 12. So I got Ixx equal to 292.71 into 10 power 6 mm power 4. So after moment of inertia, we have to calculate shear stress at the junction of the web and flange. Nothing but these are the junctions. Okay, this is the web and these are the flanges. We have to calculate junction portion. So here tau 1 equal to F into Ay bar by Ib 1. Okay, this is our first equation. So we are having F value, shear force, that is 200 kN, which is given in question, and area. So area is nothing but L into B. So this one, 200 into 25. This one L and this one B. I got 5000 mm square. And next, Y bar. So Y bar is nothing but, so this entire depth is 350. So half of this portion is 175. Okay, if I consider axis like this, see here I draw this x portion and y portion. So from here to here it is 175. So 175 minus 25/2, actually we are calculating this one, here to here, centroid of this portion. So from here to here one value, and up to here it is nothing but this total distance is 25. So half of this 25 is 25/2, and remaining is 175. So I got 162.5 mm and B1 equal to 200 mm, which is given in question. B1. After that we are going to calculate tau 1 equal to, I substitute all the values in the equation, F into A into Y bar by this equation, F into a into y bar by I into b1. So I substituted, I got this value. After that, using the relation of shear stress and width of the section, tau 1 by tau 2 equal to b2 by b1. Okay, so now tau equal to, we know the equation, f into a into y bar by I into b. So in this, I'm calculating tau 2 equal to tau 1 into b1 by b2. So I substituted all the values, I got tau 2. So after that, maximum shear stress at the neutral axis is given by, we know the formula, tau max equal to f into area by I into b. So area is nothing but a into y bar, a1 y1 plus a2 y2 by I into b. So a1 is nothing but first flange 200 into 25, I got this one. And a2 is nothing but web portion 12.5 into 175 minus 25. So this is the, suppose this is 1 and this is 2. Okay. Next, y1 is first centroid and y2 is neutral axis above and neutral axis below. So I got both the values and I substituted all these. I got tau max. So after calculating all these values, we have to draw the shear stress distribution. So this is our given I section. So first I am going to draw the baseline here, tau 0 and tau 0. So tau 1 value 2.77 newton per mm square. So tau 1 is 2.77 newton per mm square and tau 2 is 44.32, and we got the tau max. So tau max we represent like this, because the load, if the load applies like this, the web buckles in this direction. So the maximum shear stress is this one. Next, again for second one, tau 2 is 44.32 newton per mm square and tau 1 is 2.77 newton per mm square. Okay, like this we solve this I section stress distribution problem. Okay, exam you have to draw this shear stress distribution. I hope you understood this. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.